we'll give a basic overview of the Joomla extension, Phoca Gallery. It's a great extension for displaying images. It has actually lots of other uses as well, shopping carts, displaying products that you're selling. But this tutorial will just look at the basics of uploading images, creating galleries, which are categories in this extension, and how to show, how to organize them and upload them. Anyways, let's get started. I'm going to show it on a client site who wants a tutorial on using Phoca Gallery. We're in the back-end administrator area of the site already, and so I'm going to go to Components and down to Phoca Gallery, and let's just go to Control Panel. So while that page is coming up in that tab, well, it's there, let me just show you at the front. I've set up some sample categories with some sample pictures. So here there's a link that links to Phoca Gallery that I've created, and you can see there's two galleries, and they're named 2012 and 2013. If I click on the 2012 gallery, we'll wait for that picture to come up. Here we go. Here's the two pictures that are in that gallery, and they're just flower examples. So I'll use this button to go back. When we look at the back end, we're in Phoca Gallery. Let's click on categories. You'll see that in categories we have the 2012 and 2013. Think of these as galleries. In Phoca Gallery, you create a category and then you add images that you've uploaded to the server, which we'll do in a little bit, to each category. And the way it works is you can upload a picture to to your server, to your account, and you can assign it to a number of galleries if you want. If you have pictures you want to appear under different themes or topics, or however you're organizing whatever galleries you're displaying. You can also create galleries within galleries for displaying your pictures. So I have on my computer a number of car pictures from with snow on them. And let's say that I'm going to create a category, or in this case, I'll use it as a gallery as well. And click New. Here we go. And I'm going to call it Winter Cars. Now, I'm going to make it a subcategory of 2012. All right. Winter Cars in 2012. And within this category, this section, I have an option to put a description for the category. And it's this exact same window that is the article editor, and it shows it so often in Joomla site. I'm using JCE editor on this site. So I'll just type a description. Here are some pictures of cars in the winter time. This is an example. All right, so that's basically all I need to do right now. You can always go and explore other settings that are in here, like the publishing options and whatnot, but I'm just going to save and close, and now we've got a category for winter cars created as a subcategory of 2012. So the next step, what we need to do is upload the pictures that we want to include in this gallery. So I'm going to click Images here in the side menu, which will take me to the Images window that shows what is uploaded already. This shows the flowers, the images, and that are there in Phoca Gallery already. But I want to upload, and these images have already been assigned to categories. But this is not where I upload the images to. This can be a little bit confusing in Phoca Gallery, but because I like Phoca Gallery because it's got so many options, so this is well worth just learning the specific steps for uploading things and managing things in the gallery, because then it will really enable you to do the things that you want to do. We want to add a bunch of images. So I'm just going to go to Multiple Add. And now you see here we have three options: upload, multiple upload, and create a folder. Now over on the right hand side here, and it shows the path, which I will blur out in this tutorial for security reasons, but it shows the path on your server where your images that you upload to Phoca Gallery are stored. And then you can also create different folders within the structure. This is very similar to Phoca Download, which manages files. You can create folders to upload your pictures to, so it's another way to organize them. So before uploading any images, I want to decide where I'm going to put those images, which folder, and it has to be displayed here in this path. So we created winter cars in 2012, so I'm going to create a folder on the server, a place to store my winter car pictures, and this just sort of helps to keep track of where the pictures are on the server for later on when I want to go and find them and assign them to a gallery or to a category. So I'm going to click on 2012, and here are the images that appear in 2012, but I'm going to make a folder for winter cars on the server here. So I go to create folder, and I'm going to go winter cars. I put a hyphen in there. I don't like to just have blank spaces and folder names. So if I go create folder, it will create it on the server, and I'll have these two images and also a folder called winter cars. So that's the folder that I want to upload these pictures that I have. And so I'll click on winter cars, and now here I am up here, Phoca Gallery 2012 winter cars. All right, next let's upload the pictures. So I'm going to click on, if you're just going to upload one picture, you could just go to upload, choose a file, and it will go to the computer, to the folder, and then you go to the folder where the one picture is you want to upload. But I have three, so I'm not going to do that. I'm going to go to multiple upload, and then I'm going to click add files, and that will allow me to pick more than just one image. I can hunt and peck all of them, or I can drag a box around them and upload them. Now I'm not going to upload these pictures right now because I've downloaded them with their file name off of the server, the web page that offered these up for free. But you see that name is really confusing for these cars, these files. That's not going to mean anything once it's listed over here like it was here in the folder with the flowers, flower one, flower two. I can kind of remember that, but just uploading the names of these files is not going to make any sense at all later on. So for instance here, you know, who, 1, 3, 2, these numbers are just not clear enough. So you have a couple of options, and what I would say is have your files named before you upload them. So for instance, if you know, here's an image, it could be a red snow car. You know, that's going to be more to you when you go to upload things. Here is snowy street. Again, you're going to remember these things. And you could rename it individually, highway. Whatever images that you want to add to Phoca Gallery, give them good file names so that once you get them on the server, you know, a few months down the road, you go looking for them, you wonder where they are, it just will be much easier to navigate than just uploading all kinds of numbered names or crazy names or the name or the number that perhaps your digital camera assigns to things as well, to images. And that's also why we want to have this folder set up here so that you have things organized the way that that makes sense for you. The other thing too is that suppose you just want to rename them quickly, you could select them all, right click on one, and select rename, and then it could just be snow cars. You rename that first one. As soon as I hit enter, they all are named the same and they're given numbers. And that's another quick way. If you've got a lot of pictures from a Christmas party, you could just say Christmas party 2012 or 2014, select them all and they'll get renumbered. You upload them and it'll be way easier to deal with. All right, so let's go to multiple upload, add files. Here's our snow cars 1, 2, and 3. I'm going to select them all. I'm going to click open, And now here they are lined up, ready to go. And I'm going to just click Start Upload. And depending on the upload speed of your internet connection and everything together on a given day, these images will start to upload and they'll be traced as that's happening. There's one that's completely uploaded. There goes another one that started. And as soon as this last one is uploaded, the page is going to refresh. And you will see now here in Phoca Gallery 2012 Winter Cars are these three images. They're not in a gallery yet, but they are on the server now. And the next step is where we add them to a gallery. All right, let's just call these images. We could add one at a time, but we're doing multiple ads. So let's just give them all the same name, Winter Cars. And the alias will be assigned by Joomla. It's published. These pictures authorized. These are all, this authorizes another feature for a different use of Phoca Gallery. And now category. Well, what category do we want these images that we've uploaded to be added to? Well, let's add them to 2012 Winter Cars. All right, category or gallery. And as soon as we select that, everything's good. And we'll just go to save and close. Now when I hit save and close, it's going to start to, I have to select all the files. There we go. When I hit save and close, it's going to not only add the images that we've uploaded and that are selected now to the gallery, but it's going to create thumbnails for them, resize them so you have thumbnails like in this example here. So I'm going to go save and close, and you'll see a picture pop up while it's making the thumbnails. As the hamsters run, there we go. There's a thumbnail being generated for Snow Cars 2, Snow Cars 3. One was already done while we were waiting for the refresh. And now here we're taken to the images. These are all the images that are in Phoca Gallery. And as assigned by shown, we can their category or Winter Cars, and we can filter over here by which ones you want to look at. So for instance, select category Winter Cars, filter out, we just want to see those. We'll be given these three: Winter Cars, Winter Cars, Winter Cars. They all have the same name, but they're different images, but they have a different file name where they are on the server. And of course, then from this point, you can go into these images that have been created in the gallery and assigned. And there's the image. You can now go down here and type a description of it and publishing options for that. All the other options that are available to do with each picture that you've loaded. I'll close that. Now when we go to the front here and refresh, we see the way this is set up, there are three galleries, 2012, Winter Cars, and 2013. And when I click on Winter Cars, those three pictures will come up. And here they are for us to view. You can open up individually in the size that your Phoca Gallery is set for. You can go through like a slideshow looking at one. You can push play. You can refresh. We will close this here. And that's a basic overview of how to add images to Phoca Gallery. I hope that helps, and hope that you enjoy working on your site. If this video is helpful, hey, leave a comment, give a thumbs up. And subscribe to the channel. That would be awesome. God bless.